Get ready to match the stars from The Price is Right, Bob Barker, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Ava Gabor, Family Feud, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Dillivant as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rutter.
Thank you very much, Johnny Olson. Thank you, friends. You're going to be thrilled that you join us because we have a beautiful bunch of gifted, gay, witty people here. And you are a handsome group, I must say. Did I look like Rudolph Valentino there?
Exactly.
I said that one day on the show and someone says, you don't look like Rudolph Valentino, you look like Leonid Brezhnev there. What do you say we greet Barb Hamilton and Gary Bly?
Hello.
We'd like to find out a little bit about each of you, if you please. Gary, we'll begin with you, sir.
I am a full-time business administration student at Cal State University, Fullerton.
Yes.
I like to play tennis. I ski when there's snow in California, which is not too often. And for a job, I'm a supervisor at a skateboard pro shop.
A skateboard pro shop.
It's something new that just opened up in Orange County.
To each his own, is what I say, Gary.
It's a job.
All right, good luck to you, sir. And you, Barb, tell us about yourself.
Well, I'm a flight attendant for one of the best airlines in the whole world, and I'm in love with the greatest guy in the whole world, and I'm from San Diego.
And you're a happy lady.
Yeah, I'm really excited to be here. I can't tell you.
Good. Well, we're delighted to have you, Barb,
Thank
and
you.
Good luck to you, too.
Thanks.
Here on Match Game PM, each of you will have three opportunities to match as many of those creatures as you possibly can. And the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner and go on to play that big money super match, which can pay off over $10,000. Okay. Gary, you're on first. You may have A or B.
I want to pick B.
B it is yes. For Gary Blythe, he says. Big Nose Ben's nose is so big.
How big is it?
Yesterday he blew it and his blank came out. Did you hear that, Gary? Big Nose Ben's nose is so big. Yesterday he blew it and his blank came out. Here we go. Big Nose Ben's nose is so big, yesterday he blew it, and his blank came out.
His brains.
His brains. Very logical answer from him.
Very logical, very logical. The actual retail... Oh, no, that's another night.
No, that's right. Cool it.
These shows all over. I'm sorry, I said I.
His eyes?
Eyes.
Well, no, that would be good...
Gene,
anything
obviously.
Anything around the head would be an acceptable answer. That's not bad
yes,
at all.
But you don't understand. There's an optometrist's convention in town.
Oh,
you see?
I see. Well, that's why they objected, naturally. What do you say?
Oh, I don't know. Can I take a little nap?
No.
No, no. I said his teeth, all 32.
All 32 teeth came out. Another possibility. Boop. Yes?
Teeth.
So we have two teeth, one pair of eyes.
Weird.
Well, what we are looking for, Ava, are brains. Big Nose Ben's nose is so big yesterday, blew it, and his blank came out. And
boy, am I smart today.
Smart?
Smart. I said brains.
Brains. Very good.
I'm not your idiot child anymore.
Oh, I love you. No, you're very good at this game, isn't she, Richard?
Yes, I also, of course, am very smart. Brave.
Yes, too.
Now, just a minute.
Too soon we get old, too late we get smart. Remember
no,
that?
No, no, it's creeping up with me. Smartness, not age. And I've got brains, too.
Oh, that's great for him. Okay. All right, Barb, here's one for you. This lady, Bernice, said,
yeah.
It's terrible being married to a movie director. He wakes me up in the middle of the night and yells, blank. It's terrible being married to a movie director. He wakes me up in the middle of the night and yells, blank.
Got it.
Herr Director. Achtung.
You're a director.
You're a director.
Okay.
Barb, Bernie said it's terrible being married to a movie director. He wakes me up in the middle of the night and yells, blank.
Action.
Action. You rascal. Okay. That little rascal said action.
Yeah. I was just thinking, if you were an older director, it might be cut.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah.
No, no, it's action.
Action. Action. One for Barb. Little action for Barb?
Well, you know Joyce is married to a director and a producer.
Yes, yes, she is.
And he, every night, he says, action!
Action! He does! Lucky girl. I'm very happy for you, both.
That's not the way I heard it. Cut!
Cut! Who says that, Joyce or... All right,
never.
Ava. He wakes me up in the middle of the night and yells, action!
You know, darling, you don't have to be a director to say that. My husband isn't, and he does say, action!
Oh! And you, darling, what is your answer?
I could have said, roll 'em. Action.
Okay, fourth of all.
I really know.
That's right.
He says, lights, camera, action.
Oh, really? Oh.
What, brownie,
8mm now, are you? Okay. So their score is 5-3 at the end of round one. Two lively, good players here, and we'll continue this game after this. Each of our players will receive this home version of the match game. Okay? All right. Thank you very much. Action. All right. Now we go to round two, and we ask, let's see, you're ahead, Barb, so we'll ask you to go first. You may have A or B.
I want B.
B. Okay. Are you hurt?
Oh. Not really.
Now let's see. Only one person, Barb. The only one you haven't matched so far is Charles Nelson O'Reilly. Charles, did you know that Howard Cosell is actually an Indian? Would you like to hear about it?
How?
His Indian name is Chief Blank Bull. Howard Cosell is actually, his Indian name is Chief Blank Bull.
It's my maiden name, Norma. That's why really they don't put us on the cover.
Now, Barb, are you ready? Charles is ready, right, Charles? No, you're not ready.
Well, he's having a lot of trouble because, you know, he's very conscientious and he's also extremely slow.
And he can't spell.
Did you know that Howard Cosell is actually an Indian, Barb? His Indian name is Chief Blank Bull.
Hairless.
What?
Hairless.
Chief Hairless Bull? You think Charles would have thought of that?
Oh, I don't know.
Charles would never think of anything.
And
like
we're
that.
Strange? I hope that airplane she works for hasn't got wingless underneath. I'm sorry, Joe. I said throw the Chief throw the.
There's the answer. He said, Chief, throw the ball. Oh. You know, Howard Cosell is famous for that sort of
better.
Thing.
Throw the ball.
Okay, Gary, we've got one for you. It goes like this.
Hairless.
The upper tier only. Now, you all remember Bob Barker on Truth or Consequences, remember?
Well, yeah. You certainly do. Is there a man, woman, or child who doesn't?
Yes.
I have an announcement to make.
Only
now.
Tonight, Ava told me what I was on Truth or Consequences.
Did you know that he's a sex symbol?
Yes. We're sharing a dressing room, and she mentioned that.
Yeah.
A sex. Here's what that means. Every time you think of sex, they hit him with a symbol.
A sex symbol.
Cut.
Anyway, the announcement I wish to make at this time is that Bob has a new game show called Tooth or Consequences. At the end of every show, Bob Barker blanks his teeth. On this new show called Tooth or Consequences. At the end of every show, he blanks his teeth.
He blanks his teeth.
Yeah, at the end of every show, he blanks his teeth.
All right.
This is yours, Gary. All right, you remember the reference to Truth or Consequences. I'm sure you've seen that. Well, Bob has a new show called
tooth or consequences, and at the end of every show, Bob Barker blanks his teeth.
He brushes his teeth.
He brushes his teeth. Okay?
Thank you.
He did a straightforward, simple, direct answer.
He did, indeed. And I want you to know, all of you, I'm only funning when I say takes out.
Really? His teeth.
Yeah.
Can I just touch him a little bit?
They're gorgeous.
By Jove, they are his. Indeed, they are.
I'm glad
his.
You took hold of the right one.
What do you say?
He had his tongue on the roof of his mouth. Like, no, I'm sorry. I said takes out.
Takes out.
See, he's such a nice young fellow. Yeah. I assume that he would be.
Brushes is what he wants.
$19,000 you'll have to pay.
Loses.
Every night he loses his teeth. All right, so there we are at the end of round two. The score remains 5-3. You both started out like a house of fire here. Now you've slowed up a little bit. All right, Bob, you're still ahead, so we'll ask you to go first again, A or B?
B.
B, here we go. Again, Charles.
You. Is he all by himself again?
You're the one.
Shoe fits.
During the New York City blackout, Sidney had a wild time.
Right on.
When the lights came back on, Sidney got the surprise of his life. He was kissing his own blank. When the lights come on again, all over the world. Having a good time?
I'm having a ball, are you?
Splendid, yes.
Don't worry, Ava.
Barb,
we'll be back in the dressing room in a minute.
During the New York City blackout, Sidney had a wild time. When the lights came back on, Sidney got the surprise of his life. He was kissing his own blank.
Hand.
Hand.
When the lights come on again, all over.
To try to tie it all up and make it beautiful, I said his hairless wife.
His hairless wife.
He's catching up. Wearing an Ava Gabor wig at the time of the blackout.
Naturally.
And not a fair guy.
All right. Now, Gary, the score is 5-3. You must match 2 to tie, 3 to win. And here we go.
Just the top row.
Just the top row again.
I wish you'd stop saying
that. We're overexposed.
You are belaboring that.
All right, let's go.
The bionic woman said there was a terrible mistake at the bionic factory. Now my bionic blanks are on upside down.
Look how Charles snapped along.
Here we go. The bionic woman said there was a terrible mistake at the bionic factory. Now my bionic blanks are on upside down.
Her boobs.
Boobs. Now, Gary, you need two to tie and 3 to win. Or 4 to tie and 6 to win, depending on how you look at it. What do you say?
Well, I say that we finally got something that Gary and I know something about, that we agree on. Boots, 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 boots.
Score is now 5-4. You?
What about me?
What about?
I resemble that remark. Boots.
Boots. Tie score.
You want to try that again?
I resemble that remark. Boobs.
Another set of C cups, and he wins the game.
Booberettes.
Booberettes wins the game. Now, Barb, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Oh, Gene, I had a ball. This
good.
Was fun.
Barb Hamilton, we've got some gifts for you together with our thanks for being here on Match Game PM. There she goes. Now we're spinning her off. We want to spin this message for you. Here we are. Now, Gary, this is a big moment for you because it's time for the Big Money Super Match. You'll look at me when I'm talking to you, and it'll work out a lot better that way, you see. If you can't hear me, you can read my lips, all right? Hey, you can win over $10,000 here. Now, to do that, we're going to have two of these audience matches for you, and whatever you win here will be multiplied by 10, and that'll be the final dollar figure you'll be playing for. Here we go. Good luck to you. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Blank vision. And the answer they gave us most often will get you $500 if you match it. Now, if you match their second most popular answer, you get $250. And then for matching the third, you get $100. and three of the six loonies will help you.
I will have Richard first.
You will have Richard.
I think you'll enjoy me. I'm going to say television.
Television. All right.
Joyce.
Joyce?
I hope this is right. Isn't there something that people get called night vision?
Night vision? Yeah.
No. Get or have?
Okay, would night vision is a...
She's thinking of night blindness. Yes.
No, all right, she's got night vision. We have to accept that as her answer. One more.
Brett.
Double vision.
Double vision, night vision, and television are the three, Gary. You've got to choose one of those now, or it is your option to give us one of your own.
Television.
Television it is. Well, I would hope they would have had the decency to say that since they were in a television studio. Let's find out right now if it's up there, and if so, where. May we see the $100 response, please? 2020 vision.
Excellent. Not me. Vision.
All right. Let's go up the ladder and look at the $250 response. Tunnel vision. Tunnel vision. Okay, here's the last chance for television. Slide it, please. We congratulate you, Gary. You've won an additional $500. That means the least amount you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. And now we're going to see how much more money you'll win with your second audience match. Go. Blank Tigers. Blank Tigers. Whom do you call on?
Richard again.
Flying Tigers.
Joyce?
I'll try again. Detroit Tigers.
Yeah! Brett.
Brett? Baby, you're on. The camera's on you.
I know, I'm looking at Roger. Something may come to me. So I just, if I concentrate, that stinks. Bengal Tigers, anyway.
Bengal Tigers, Detroit Tigers, and Flying Tigers are the three. Now, think about it, Gary. Have you got one of your own, or do you want to choose one of those?
The first thing I thought of was Detroit Tigers.
Detroit Tigers. You were born there?
In Detroit.
No kidding. Okay, I lived in Detroit for 20 minutes once. Well, we hope Detroit Tigers is up there someplace. Let's go up the ladder and begin down at the bottom with Detroit Tigers. May we see it, please? Flying Tigers. All right, there's Richard's answer. I think that's a good omen there, Gary. You may get it. May we see the $250 response? Bingo.
Oh, I take it back. I apologize.
You got two out of three. And boy, the big one ought to be up there. May we see it, please? Yeah! Barbara, get a little kiss there.
I get a kiss?
What?
That's pretty good. Is she a good kisser?
Oh, yes.
Want to kiss her again?
That wouldn't be a bad idea.
Go over and give her another kiss.
Oh, yeah, this is fun.
Cut! Action!
Gene?
Yes?
You didn't ask him. Maybe he wants to kiss Richard, too.
Want to kiss Richard?
No, thank you.
Okay. All right, now, Gary, you've won another $500. We multiply that by 10, makes another $5,000. Add that to the previous $5,000. You're shooting for a pot of $10,000 here. Now, we want to give you that money, Gary, but there's one little hurdle you have to get over here before we can give you that sum, and you must match one celebrity exactly.
It'll be Richard.
Oh.
Why?
All right. You will kiss him if you win.
I'll shake his hand.
We'll shake.
Oh, all right. A little handshake will be sufficient. Here we go. Here it is. Good luck to you. Here it is. Blank it away. Blank it away.
Spell the way.
A-W-A-Y. Blank it away. A-W-A-Y. All right, Gary, give us the answer that Richard has written on the card, and we give you $10,000 additional to what you won already. There it is.
Take it.
Yeah! Take it away. Take it away, he says. All right, Richard, he says, take it away. We'll match you for $10,000. What do you say?
I was thinking of the diet. When you sit at the table, you
push it away. Yeah.
Or take it.
Congratulations, Gary Wise. While he's applauding and celebrating, we'll do a little business with America here.
There's your souvenir card right there. That's it. Andrew.
Congratulations to Gary.
Okay. Come on back here.
We'll be back in a moment.
This fellow, Gary Blythe, is very, very happy. He has a total of $11,000. We congratulate him. Join us next week for Match Game PM, when we'll try and give away more money. Have a lot of beautiful celebrities like these here. Thank you, Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive a Codaphone Message Center, a beautiful decorated telephone with built-in automatic answering system. You'll never miss an important call with Codaphone. A new improved Breck shampoo. Now you can see, feel, and smell what new improved Breck shampoo does for your hair. And the Maxipedes by Simmons, designed in cooperation with an orthopedic surgeon, features a built-in bed board in the box spring for super comfort and support from Simmons. And Turtle Extra, extra easy, extra durable, extra brilliant. New Turtle Extra, the extra hard shell car wax, the top of the line from Turtle Wax. And Olympic overcoats made to help cover old paint for good with a top acrylic finish that lasts for years. Put on the overcoat, Olympic overcoat. And Bardol quality oil additives, because engines can't survive by oil alone. Add Bardol the next time you change your oil. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.